Thank you for joining us today and on this special occasion. My name is Lizzie Izquierdo, and I'm your Associate Dean of Students. In a few minutes, we're going to start our ceremony. But before we begin, just a few gentle reminders so we can enjoy our celebration today is that we ask you to silence your phones. So just double check and make sure your phones are silenced. The second thing is that we're going to ask to keep the aisles clear. We have a photographer here today who's going to be taking pictures, and all of these will be free to your students. So just so you know, the students will be getting the link after the show, after today's events. This is also being filmed, so the video recording will be available for you as well. And in a few short moments, we'll begin, and your MC will be Dr. Emma Cuenca, who's the director of our pre-licensure program. So thank you.
Good afternoon and welcome, everyone. I am Dr. Emma Cuenca, Director of the Pre-Licensure Programs at the UCLA School of Nursing. I am pleased to welcome you this afternoon to the Blue and Gold Ceremony, honoring our 2024 Master of Science in Nursing degree students. Or graduates, I should say. Our 2024 MECN graduates will soon join the largest group of healthcare providers in the world, nurses, with over 17 million strong around the world, and with 4 million in the United States alone. Students, next Saturday, you will join nearly 10,000 individuals who graduated from the UCLA School of Nursing and begin a new relationship as a UCLA alumni. We are all Bruins, embracing values of respect, integrity, diversity, and compassion. And in this spirit of nursing, let us continue to help others. Pinning ceremonies have symbolized caring for the sick, selflessness efforts to attend the injured, and dedication to restore health. Pinning was adopted in academia to identify students who had completed their entry-level nursing education. It is also a symbol of the nursing students' hard work and dedication towards their coursework and clinicals. Today, we're celebrating the successful completion of the hard work that you have put into your nursing education. We know that this ceremony has great personal meaning to you and to your family and friends here today with you. When you wear this pin, wear it with pride and remember the faculty, the preceptors, and classmates who were part of your journey. This school nursing pin was chosen by our students last year. The lamp in the middle symbolizes the transforming work that nurses do. It symbolizes goodwill, reliability, and compassion. Olive branch, traditionally known as a symbol of peace, the olive branch is a perfect visual representation for the feeling that nurses evoke in their patients and their loved ones, especially during very difficult times. We have a surprise for you. In addition to receiving a UCLA pin, you will also receive a certificate from the Barcos Nightingale Foundation for a complimentary set of scrubs. Barco also has a rich history in providing uniforms to the nursing profession. We are proud to say that as of this year, the uniform UCLA School of Nursing students We're very grateful to them for thinking of our graduates. Representing Barcos today in our audience is Iris Amanao, Director of Creative Projects. Please give her a round of applause. Thank you, Iris. It is my honor to introduce the Dean of the UCLA of Nursing, Dean Lin Zan. Dr. Zan joined UCLA in August of 2021 as the 8th Dean of the School of Nursing after serving as Dean and Chief Nursing Officer of the University of Memphis Lewenberg College of Nursing for two campuses between 2010 to 2021. Prior, she served as the founding dean at Massachusetts College of Pharmacy and Health Sciences in Boston, as a chief academic officer for three campuses, including Boston, Worcester, Massachusetts, and Manchester, New Hampshire. Dean Zan is a fellow of the American Academy of Nursing, and since 2001, she has served on the Academy's expert panels on aging, on global health, and on the Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion Committee. Please join me in welcoming Dean Zan to the podium.
Thank you, Dr. Krinker, for your very kind introduction. Good afternoon, UCLA School of Nursing Macon graduates. Wow, you did it. So I also want to thank families, friends, my wonderful colleagues, faculty and staff here today. Let me take a moment to thank the families and the friends, and thank you for investing your time, of course, your patience. You wish the degree could be completed in 3 months. That does not happen. So your patience and also your tangible support, psychologically, emotionally, of course, financially. Now you feel very proud, maybe relieved. You don't have to pay the tuition anymore. So the families and friends, please stand if you can, be recognized. Thank you. Thank you. Please be seated. To all Macon graduates, I want you to remember to honor the professors and also you call faculty. By the national data, on the average, nursing faculty work 60 to 73 or 75 hours per week. And you only see them when they are teaching you or in the clinical. But you don't see them after that. They're still thinking about and still continue to see what the best knowledge they can offer to you, how they sharpen your clinical skills, and how to prepare you to be a knowledgeable, competent, compassionate, and also the nurses and going to meet the tremendous challenges in the healthcare, across healthcare setting and ecosystems. That means you are going to be a healthcare providers. When you practice nursing, and you will become a glue in the healthcare system and play your leadership role 24/7 and 365 days across the health continuum and across the human lifespan. So therefore, sometimes the students like to complain about our professor. And they call our professors too tough. And I remember one of the world-renowned physicists, the professor in physics, this is what he said. The best professors gave you the question you cannot answer, but they do not give you the answer you cannot question. So sometimes you want to know the answer. You can pass the exam. Professor will not give to you. Very simple reason. Because they want you to be educated. They want you to be educated in the top one public university, UCLA, and the UCLA School of Nursing. So our professors and the faculty, please stand, be recognized. Thank you. Please, you know, my role as the dean is to learn how to take care of them. I want to thank our wonderful staff. You know, they are here make today's event possible. And of course, on your journey, and some of you or many of you know, if you have a question, when you feel anxious, sometimes you say, oh, what am I going to do? You make a phone call. You send an email, and they serve you. And you know what the most beautiful part of our staff? They serve you with a smile. They don't complain. That's wonderful. Now, for all the Macon graduates, you enter the nursing profession when the world is polarized, what do we call crazy? But we also have multiple challenges you are going to face. But remember, you must anchor yourself with the professional responsibility and accountability. You know, one of my dear, dear friends, this is what she talked. When you have a professional identity, you don't complain. You hold yourself responsible, accountable, because you have a mission. So your mission is to provide competent, compassion, and with the humanity and the integrity to serve our patients, families, and communities. And also remember to continue the UCLA School of Nursing legacy, which is innovation. Always keep your curiosity. Don't stay where you are. Our second one is the leadership. The leadership is not defined by the position. Leadership is defined by what you do. The leadership is the humility, generosity, commitment square. That is the leadership. So you all can play a major leadership role in the healthcare settings. Today, it is my great pleasure to introduce one of our Broom leaders, Dr. James Simmons. Dr. Simmons actually graduated from our very first cohort of DNP program, which is the Doctor in Nursing Practice program. By the way, in nursing, the train is out of station. For in the future, all advanced nurse practitioners must have a terminal degree. That is a doctoral degree. So Jim has combined his experience, expertise, and talent in the healthcare and communication to reach out and touch, educate, and advocate for the underserved individuals, communities, and populations, particularly for at-risk and populations. He is the founder of the vibrant online community called Ask NP. NP stands for Nurse Practitioner, a multimedia platform to create a space of voices for the vulnerable communities and serve as the trusted resource for real, relatable, reliable, and health information. This is very important because given the technology, social media we have, there are tons of fake news, disinformation, but the scientific-based information is very important for nurses and to advocate, to voice that, and to really help our people and the communities. He's also the founding member and the continued ambassador for the CDC, which is Center for Disease Control, Let's Stop HIV Together campaign. Dr. Sims continues to emerge as the role model and voice for the vulnerable. We are so proud of him to be our Brown graduates. Please join me. Welcome Dr. James Simmons.
Good afternoon, everybody. That was close. All right. I grew up in the church, so I'm down with the little call and response. All right. So if you feel so moved while I'm talking, if you don't like what I'm saying, I don't know. Give me a little feedback, okay? I'm used to that. Are you absolutely terrified yet? Haha. Yes. Someone said yes. You're being honest with yourself. Good. You should be. Absolutely terrified. I'm just kidding. Or am I? Before we go any further, I do want to extend my deepest and heartfelt thank you to Dean Zahn for asking me to be here today and say a few words, as well as the rest of the distinguished faculty that are here, and also the tremendous staff. Y'all are amazing. Most importantly, as someone who has literally been in your seat before, and I'll get to that, I also want to say thank you to the parents, the kiddos, the partners, the friends, the neighbors, the mechanics, the Uber drivers, the everyone in here who was like your support system. I think we need to give them another round of applause. Okay, now graduates, it's just me and you. We're just gonna talk. We're gonna have a little conversation here, okay? So ignore everybody else that's here. You ready for that? You ready for just us to talk? Because in this world where everyone has a brand, right? Everyone's got a thing that they're known for. I'm a little bit known as the guy in nursing who's gonna, like, to use some old school language, keep it real, right? That's a little bit of what I do, which is why I was surprised, actually, that Dean Zahn asked me to speak. Because she's a obviously very smart woman. I think she knows she's taking a calculated risk in asking me to do this. I promise, Dean, I won't embarrass you, okay? But as much as a public speaker as I am, this is scary. It's scary to be up here. It's scary to have the next generation of nurses and their support systems hanging on to your every word, right? This is a little bit terrifying, even though I do this frequently. But with platform and privilege comes power and responsibility, and this is a responsibility that I do not take lightly. So I need to let you know what's coming up next in your life. Now, I do this from time to time. In fact, I think I did this with your class. I have this entire program that I teach called Yes, It Exists, Life After Nursing School and How to Actually Use Your Degree. And generally speaking, this is a well-received presentation. Sometimes there can be some uncomfortable, maybe even scary truths in there, but they are truths that I think are really important. And so on a day like today that you're going to remember for the rest of your life, I want to talk about some of those truths. Number one, you should be terrified, but don't let it stop you. I am one of those pesky career change nurse practitioners. Y'all are familiar with this. My original degree is in broadcast journalism and mass communications from Drake University in Des Moines, Iowa, 193 billion years ago. Go Bulldogs. I took that degree and I turned it into a pretty successful broadcasting, communications, public relations career. My last job in that world was with PepsiCo. I specifically worked on the Gatorade brand. I got to handle athletes like Candace Parker. It was amazing. And they're fast-tracking me to this like upper management career, and I'm killing it. I'm doing great. I'm loving it. But the entire time, I have this career that's growing and whatever. I could not shake this feeling that I wanted to be a nurse. I kind of always knew that I wanted to be a nurse, though. But when you're the biracial, fat, effeminate, queer kid growing up in Nebraska in the 80s and 90s, you're not exactly like running around also telling everybody that you want to be a nurse, right? Like at that time, there was a lot of stigma about men being in nursing. And I was getting my ass beat, and I wasn't trying to give the bullies more fuel for their fire, right? So I decided, well, I guess I'm a pretty good writer, and I'm a pretty good communicator, so I'm gonna stick with that as my career. Until about 15 years ago or so, when I just finally could not ignore that little nurse in the back of my brain who just kept saying, but James, you're a nurse, right? So I was terrified, but eventually, I didn't let the fear stop me and I jumped. So I had been working on my prerequisites already. I was smart about that. When I applied to the MECN equivalent program at the University of Illinois Chicago, go Flames, for some reason they let me in, I don't know why, and it was brutal. It was awful. It was terrible. You guys can probably. But it was also where I found my people. And I will just say this specifically to y'all, the people that I went through my MECN equivalent program are still very, very much my support system now, and that was 14, 15 years ago. We still text, we still talk to each other when we have career changes, when we have lose parents, when a couple of them left the profession, things like that. We actually are still very much each other's bedrock. So I really do say that when I found my people, and we're literally scattered all over the world, but these are your people, hold tight to them, okay? Through that program, I passed the NCLEX.
You will too. You'll pass.
And then I spent 3 years at the bedside while I worked on my adult gerontology acute care nurse practitioner. And I've been practicing as either an intensivist or a hospitalist since 2014. So I'm cruising along at the time. I'm like super happy in my career. I'm a nurse practitioner. This is awesome. Until that damn school bug bit me again in 2018. And so I decided to come back to the inaugural cohort of the Doctor of Nursing Practice program here at UCLA. And that first year of that program, it was flawless and perfect in every single way. We can talk more about that outside later. All right, so now I'm Dr. James Q. Simmons. I'm loving my nursing life. I'm cruising along again, but really missing the media. So I took the nursing, and I took the media, and I merged them. Now I'm frequently seen on TV, radio, podcasts, big YouTubers, big TikTok profiles, on stage, all these different places, with grand plans for the future and how we can level up the world's education about their own health through the media, and more importantly, level up nurses being seen as experts in the media, which I'm really passionate about. So from coming out of the closet to generational stigma, to changing careers, to going back to school 3 times, to tackling Hollywood now, to ultimately deciding that I have to live in my truth at all times, each of those has been and is still accompanied sometimes by like unbridled, nearly paralyzing terror. But I don't let it stop me. Number 2, you should be terrified. But let it stop you. It's hard to tell when the exact moments will happen, but they will happen and you will know it. Most of them will be towards the beginning of your career, but you will have them throughout your career. But you will have these moments where you will be absolutely terrified to do something. a new IV insertion technique, a new medication, a new type of conversation with a patient or family, a new diagnosis you've never seen, a new specialty, a new facility, a new body fluid on your body. Like, all of these things you should be terrified of. A healthy dose of fear has gotten the human race very, very far. A healthy dose of the right kind of fear has also gotten the profession of nursing very far too. And here's what I mean. If you don't know something, stop and look it up. Stop and ask a colleague. Stop and ask someone who has experience in this thing that is new to you. Most importantly, stop and ask your gut, your heart, and your head in that order. In this like TikTokification of the world where everything needs to be like seen and consumed and taken all in 8 seconds or less, we're being reprogrammed to act first, and dare I even say react first, and then think later. Now, okay, this does not mean for all my Virgos, Pisces, and Libras in the room that you stop and absolutely overthink every single thing that you do. So you know, this is my thing. So you know when you go to a restaurant and you sit down and you're handed a menu, and then it's like 15 minutes later before the server comes over to ask you what you want to eat, and there's always one person in the group who still doesn't know what they want 15 minutes later. There's always one, right? That one person is also a nurse sometimes. And in our profession, regardless of specialty, a healthy dose of pausing, stopping, and reflecting before you act is good. Just don't be that person in the restaurant either, okay? When you are terrified of this new thing and your gut is telling you to stop, listen to your gut. No one on earth has a more refined, more insightful, more intuitive gut than a nurse. Sometimes when you're terrified in that moment, it's because you should be. And you understand that you might very specifically have someone's life in your hands. That's good. You should be terrified in those moments and let it stop you. But also know that your gut is only 1/3 of this decision-making process. Respect it, listen to it, but know that your incredible heart and your even more powerful intellect, the three of those things will guide you to making the right decision. Number three, can you guess what I'm gonna say? You should be terrified, but let it motivate you. Just like that healthy dose of fear might stop you from making a critical mistake, a healthy dose of fear can be the catalyst for pushing you to live the life that only you know you want to live, to live the life that you are destined for. Your fear should be complacency. Your fear should be that of living someone else's truth. Your fear should be that of doing and feeling like you have to act the way that somebody else tells you you need to feel or act. Your fear should be not understanding that you have an incredibly powerful voice as a nurse right now to do so much good. You practice under your own license, full stop. So yes, the current hierarchy of medicine dictates that sometimes you have to wait for a provider to give you an order before you can react, right? Like that's, we all got that part. It's not necessarily what I mean. What I do mean is that you don't have to be beholden to that provider. What that does mean is that you get to use that gut and heart and brain of yours. That doesn't mean that you cannot understand and act and operate at the absolute top of the scope of your practice and at the absolute top of what your license will allow you to do. That you can be a part of, and sometimes the leader of, when you are ready, the interdisciplinary healthcare team. Don't ever forget that. And I don't mean this in just like a hospital or clinic setting. I mean this globally. So everybody else, you guys can check back in now, okay? We're all part of the conversation now. The nurses in this room have heard this 100 trillion thousand times. We've been voted 22 years running by the American public as the most ethical, some people translate that as most trusted, profession. That's something to really be proud of, and I honestly am. But I'm also the guy who's always asking, okay, so what are we doing with those ethical principles? What are we doing with the American people's trust? As a nurse, you have a certain, how do you say, je ne sais quoi, that gives you power and influence to make the right kinds of change, to fight against injustices, genocide, kidnapping, inequity, misinformation, whatever your thing is that drives you and drives our collective humanity. Also, like, no tea, no shade if Botox is your thing. It's fine. Listen, I'm a big believer that multiple truths can exist simultaneously. The altruistic nature of what we do, of being nurses, drives many of us to think that we constantly have to be saving our families, our patients, the community, the world, often at the sacrifice of taking care of ourselves. So just because you have the power to do so, if your spirit ain't right, you don't have to be saving the world constantly. There ain't a damn thing wrong, nor should you feel any shame about spending some time in aesthetics nursing if that's your thing, right? I mentioned earlier that with platform and privilege come power and responsibility. So I will leave you with this final thought, and it is one of those hard truths I was telling you about. It is your responsibility to understand that no one is going to take care of you except for you. I hope I've been a little bit of an example of the multitude of possibilities. Like, you're good. Like, the world is waiting for you. There is so much that you can do. That is an incredible amount of privilege and power that you have right now. Your friends, your families, your loved ones, the world, everyone will want to take from you. And to some degree, that's okay. That's like kind of what we do as nurses. But very rarely will society, as it is structured right now, and even the people in your life who love you the most, truly know what you need to keep your gut, your heart, and your head in the right place. As hard of a pill as it is to swallow, that one's on you. Fight for it at all times. Now go be absolutely terrified, and let that fear excite you when needed, motivate you when needed, stop you when needed, all of it with the full knowledge and understanding that you have wisely chosen the absolute best profession to allow you to lead a most incredible life. Thank you.
Well, Dr. Simmons, thank you for those inspiring words. It is my pleasure this time to introduce Dr. Zarina Khan, our faculty speaker for our Blue and Gold Ceremony. Dr. Khan! Was selected by the class to speak to serve as our faculty speaker today.
Thank you. Let's see, where is my speech? Yeah, there it is. Okay. Well, I am very honored to have been chosen. I have told you all countless times how special you are. I think out of the 3 years of I teaching here at UCLA, I've never gotten so close to a group of students. So not only have I have taught you, you have taught me many lessons. So let me just start off and get that out the way, okay? So good afternoon to all our esteemed faculty, honored guests and family, and most importantly, to our remarkable graduating class of nursing students. To the graduating class, I offer my heartfelt congratulations. Each one of you has exhibited dedication, resilience, and unwavering determination throughout your journey to this moment. The path to becoming a nurse is not an easy one. It requires sacrifice, late nights, and countless hours of study. But it is a path that you have chosen willingly, driven by a passion to make a difference in the lives of others. In your time as nursing students, you have not only mastered the complexities of medical science, but also embraced the art of caring. You have comforted the distressed, advocated for the voiceless, and provided a beacon of hope in the times of darkness. You have shown empathy in the face of adversity and kindness in the moments of despair. And for that, you deserve our utmost respect and admiration. As you step into the world as fully fledged nurses, remember the lessons you have learned within these walls. Remember the importance of empathy, for it is the cornerstone of nursing care. Remember the value of teamwork, for together, we can achieve far more than we could ever do alone. And remember the privilege of being entrusted with the care of others, for it is a responsibility that should never be taken lightly. But perhaps most importantly, remember to never lose sight of why you chose this noble profession. In the hustle and bustle of busy hospital corridors, it can be easy to become jaded or overwhelmed. But always remember the faces of those whose lives you have touched, the smiles of gratitude, and the moments of triumph against all odds. Let these memories serve as a constant reminder of the profound impact you have the power to make each day. As you go forth from this place, know that you carry with you the hopes and the dreams of countless individuals whose lives you will touch. You are the healers, you are the caregivers, and the advocates for those in need. And though the road may be very challenging ahead, I have no doubt that every one of you is more than capable of rising to the occasion. In closing, I leave you with the words of Florence Nightingale, the pioneer of modern nursing, who once said, now listen, it's very important, my last lecture to you guys. I attribute my success to this. I never gave or took any excuse. So you guys have no excuse. You will be successful. Okay? May her words serve as guiding light on your journey ahead, illuminating the path towards a future filled with purpose, fulfillment, and endless possibilities. Congratulations to the graduating class of nursing students. The world awaits your unique brand of compassion and care. Go forth and make your mark, for you are destined to shine brightly in the world of healthcare. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Khan. In a few days, you will no longer be students but graduates of the UCLA School of Nursing. To welcome you as soon-to-be alumni, I would like to introduce Chris Clore, Executive Director of Development and Alumni Relations for the UCLA School of Nursing. Chris.
Thank you, Dr. Cuenca. My name is Chris Clore, and I am the new Executive Director of Development and Alumni Relations here at the UCLA School of Nursing. I could not be happier to welcome all of you to the Bruin alumni family. While I'm new to UCLA, the School of Nursing has been part of this community for 75 years. The past 75 years have seen stark shifts in the role of nurses and nurse education. Here in Westwood, this began with founding Dean Lulu Wolf Hassenplug moving education from the hospital to the classroom and removing the traditional nursing cap. In my reading about the school and our history, I was struck by a quote from Dean Hassenplug. It takes a good deal of courage to break old patterns. As the next generation of nurses, I hope that you carry this mentality that built the UCLA School of Nursing with you every day. With 75 years of history, you are joining a Bruin Nurse Network of almost 10,000 alumni that spans practice areas, multiple generations, and 10 countries. Your network doesn't stop there, however. In 1 week, you will become one of 660,000 living UCLA alumni and have access to vast resources to help advance you both personally and professionally. As you enter this next phase of your life, I and the School of Nursing ask for one thing: stay connected. Whether it be through the Alumni Association, reading our newsletters, following along on social media, attending events, giving back, becoming a mentor or a preceptor for the next generation of students. We are stronger together with you as an active member of our Bruin Nurse community. And just as a small bit of housekeeping, we do have a QR code where you can join our alumni group and receive an ID badge with UCLA Nursing on it there. But back to the speech here. You became a Bruin Nurse the moment you were admitted to the UCLA School of Nursing. And as you leave, you'll keep that moniker with you forever, building on our 75-year legacy in communities around California, the nation, and the world. We are so proud of you and grateful that you've become Bruin Nurses. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chris. Now is the time in our ceremony to present some awards. The students have nominated and voted for the classmate they feel best embodies the three aspects of nursing: leadership, empathy, and being a team player. To present these awards is Barbara Demon.
So, as always with nursing, you just figure it out, and we're going to figure it out right now. Okay. True nurse, you will do anything with nothing and make it happen. So, all right. Okay. All right. So, I am so honored and grateful to present the peer-nominated awards. So, this is awards chosen by your cohort, choosing someone that you feel embodies these attributes. And in a way, I think that's one of the highest honors, is to by your own peers be recognized and seen. So we'll start with leadership. And the first person I'd like to present the leadership award nominated by your own peers would be Gary Soloff. So. And moving along to the next leadership award nominated by all of you would be Danny Ramone. Good job. Let's stand to the side. And moving along, continuing with the leadership award nominated by all of you, and probably not a surprise, falling right with Danny is Mahak Kar. We thank you for all of your leadership in doing the things that many people didn't want to do. So thank you.
Appreciate that.
Yes, yeah, thank you. Thank you. Okay, and then just keeping things rolling and moving along, we would like to move into the award for empathy, which is quite a profound statement. Would you like them to sit down, or should they? Okay, you can sit down now. Okay, yes, okay. Great job, yes, thank you. moving along with empathy, really such a profound quality, empathy being able to place yourself in someone else's, in their experience and being able to relate to them. And what happens in a time of stress is that when we're stressed, sometimes the best side of us doesn't come out. And I would like to say that all of your two-year nursing program was very stressful. So the idea that to have somebody with this quality of empathy of everything is quite beautiful. So let us put our hands together for Andrew Gruen. And last but not least, for voted by you for team player, someone you want on your team, and without a doubt, yes, Ryan Troutman.
Congratulations. At this time, we will present our Meccan students with their nursing pin. Reading the names of each student will be Professor Kristen Schultz. This year, students have selected 1 to 2 pinners to join them as they receive their pin. Assisting with the pins will be Dr. Barbara Bates Jensen, our Associate Dean of Academic Affairs and Programs. The Student Affairs staff will pull the students and their pinners one row at a time and help them line up against the left-hand wall. Students, please hand your name card to Professor Kristen Schultz so that she could read your name. And Dr. BBJ, we call her BBJ, will hand the lanyard to your pinner. Your pinner will place the lanyard on you. Be sure to face the audience so that we can see you receive your pin. And now I present Professor Kristen Schultz. Thank you.
Come on over. I'm so happy to be here with you all. Oh, I'm going to cry. Okay. Kyle Anthony Salter. Dynasty Wilds. Lonnie Mojica. Marissa Ortiz. Yeah.
Michael Bishop Smith. Erica Ozeki. Mishka Khan Alkire. Andrew Gruen. Zach Carmen. Lorna Sagastume. Christina Perez. Lizette Fontaza. Maital Lahijani. Celine Manchuri. Samantha Mann. Brigida Fields. Anna Mae Parsons. Mahak Kaur. Yeah. Sierra Kim. Tiffany Zhao. Courtney Merrick. Gary Sola. Emily Vies. Emily Wu. Ryan Troutman. Bella Kim. Danny Ramon. Orion Shoshani. Shay Brown. Jessica Tien Chuk Pham. Delilah Calderon. Lydia Yi Yuan Kim. Kathy Fu Xiang Chu. Sydney Alvarado. Matthew Vargas Pena. Yeah. Markel Bishop. Sagan Gabrendrias. Valeya Johnson. Adese Anoha. Lindsay Palm. Arlene Mann. Cheyenne Cox. Roxana Barba. Jeanette Escobedo. Vanessa Martinez Hernandez. Jasmin Gonzalez. Jessica Wrighton. Kelly Stolp. Amari Williams. Kayla Hofsty. Yeah. Melanie Ortiz. Alana Montero. Chelsea Cardenas. Christiana Cherie Craig. Amelia Zhao. Karen Martinez. Nofshadian. Cynthia Perez. J. Tor. David Yesai Gonzalez. Shaka Busan. Lauren Rodriguez. Osareme Olog Bosele. Teray Williams. Joseph Francisco Meza. Beatriz Oriana. Congratulations. Congratulations on reaching this milestone today. Wear your pin. Yay! Wear your pin with pride and always remember the values of empathy, leadership, and teamwork that are the essence of a nurse. We are so proud of you. Yes, let's give the students a last round of applause. We look forward to seeing you at commencement next Saturday. Good luck as you embark on your nursing careers. We sincerely hope that you have enjoyed your time here at UCLA and that you have made many friends and cherished memories. We hope you will keep in touch and return as future doctoral students. We are happy to share with you that there's a photo booth outside for you and light refreshments in the courtyard. Graduates, please join us these steps outside for a group picture. Congratulations again, graduates!
Woo! The video.
Oh, wait. There's something that I missed as an MC, okay? There's a video that was prepared for everybody to view. Yes, yes, yes. Congratulations again, graduates of 2024. Woohoo!